All right, so here we are in the map that Astro created. I'm going to spell out his letters for the rest of this time so I don't set him off. So this is the map that he created of my crib. There are some things that it got right, and there are also some things that it got wrong. So, for instance, my kitchen is just that. It's not the second, it's not the half on the left. It's only that it's a galley-style kitchen, so it's the narrow space on the right there. So, but the app gives you the option to edit rooms with some dotted lines. This is not super intuitive, but I'm going to try and put a line. So it says add now. So it's going, we're going to drag this guy over here. And what I've had, I'm not really sure. Yeah, you can, so if you pinch, you can pinch to rotate. And we're pushing the kitchen just over that way. So that is more like it in terms of the way that the kitchen is set up. But the idea here is that you basically can edit the map to have it be a little bit better than the initial exploration that our friend has done for us. And then so after you add a boundary, then you can say save and sync. So now, so we're going to go ahead and do that. So saving and syncing to the cloud. So this is our friend remembering basically that the kitchen is that space over there. And the lines don't need to be perfect. As you can see, mine's a little bit crooked-ish, and that's fine. And then it looks like there's an overlap between the living room and the dining room. So my dining room is a very small area. I believe that M thing is my table, my dining room table. So I have an open floor plan here for the living room and dining room. They're basically the same room. If I suppose I just could have called the whole thing the living room, but I do want him to be able to go and hang out in the dining area sometime. So that was the idea behind doing that. And so, yeah, so in terms of the lines, I'm going to need to draw an additional line. So we're going to say edit rooms again. And then we're going to say add, and it's going to put that sort of the line that's like that. So my dining room is basically here. And if I can, I want to try and make the line a little bigger. So, you can also zoom into the map to make that go a little bit more smoothly. And then I'm trying to, it doesn't want me to draw a boundary line there, but that's okay. So we're going to say, so I want him to think of the dining room as being right there. And so this is the idea. So you basically just go through, and the app is not very intuitive, and the little gazintas are kind of hard to move around the screen, but it's worth doing because this is how you'll get the most value out of it in terms of being able to recognize your different living spaces. So I would say spend the time, and you can always come back to this. So it's not like you have to do it all in one fell swoop. So you can kind of perfect this as you go. And I think Astro also will sniff around and learn your layout better over time as well. At least I think that was my experience before. So yeah, so I'm not seeing how I can, did I just expand the line a little bit? I did. And I wanted to, I don't like, yeah, this is, see, this should go. So this is, yeah, this is the tricky part of it. So you need to kind of, you've got to pinch and zoom to move things around and so forth. But the dining room is looking more like the dining room now already, which is good. So I can edit that waypoint. I'm going to drag this down just a little bit. It looks like it'll let me put that there. So that's roughly the space of the dining room, sort of. It's actually, if I get that saw line to go down lower, but you've got to play around with the boundary lines a little bit. So anyhow, this is what you want to do. I hope this is helpful, and will, you know, at least give you the basics in terms of how you go about editing the map. But like I said, well worth doing, because then you'll be able to get him to go to certain rooms. And, you know, if you had a kid's room, for instance, you want the boundary lines to be just right. So if you want him to deliver things to the kids and so forth. But yeah, for all intents and purposes, it's a little kludgy and clunky to use this app. And hopefully Amazon will make this more user-friendly. But the idea is that you want a complete picture of your home. and then he will be able to navigate around and so forth. So in terms of the initial setup, so this is basically it. So the video series is, I think it's either I believe it's four parts actually. So we did the initial configuration, then we did the demo, and then we did the app setup, and then we did the mapping. So I'm going to create a playlist for all these videos so we can string them all together, and hopefully, you know, you can get your Astro setup up and running, and that this was somewhat helpful. If so, please give me a like and subscribe to some of these, like on some of these videos, and subscribe to the channel. I do all sorts of videos on all things tech, and I will do much more on Astro, including some troubleshooting and some demos and some other things, but I'm really loving this thing initially. And I know that there's been some, you know, sort of negative press out there, and I can see why, because it's not perfect. I mean, it definitely gets a little clues, it gets a little lost sometimes, but I think he's super cute and a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to doing some more exploring with my new little pet here. Anyhow, please, I hope to see you in the next video. Please subscribe. Cheers.